Good morning, children. I am your social science teacher. Today we'll start with the civics chapter, Directive Principles of State Policy. See, children, this chapter is about the administration. How to improve the functioning. So, just if you think of suggestions for your school administration to improve the functioning, the framers of the Constitution of India prescribed certain guidelines to the future governments to ensure the smooth functioning of our country. So, these guidelines are known as the Directive Principles of State Policy in this chapter, children. So, see, children, immediately after our independence, our great leaders thought of the people should have the rights. So, they wanted to frame the principles, rules and regulations for the people. That is the rights, fundamental rights they wanted. In the previous chapter, we have studied about that, children. So, today, we are going to study about the Directive Principles of State Policy. See, when India attained the biggest challenge before the framers of the Constitution of India was to ensure it was only thinking that they need equality and well-being of all the citizens' children. So, they had already outlined the fundamental rights of the citizens. So, however, those could be brought into the effect only with the supplementation of appropriate policies. So, when the framers all joined together to frame the constitution for our country immediately after our independence, they thought that it should have equal rights to the citizens. So, those could be brought into effect only with the supplementation of appropriate policies. There should be some policies, but it was also not possible to bind the future governments with certain policy decisions. So, thus what they did is, they incorporated certain guidelines which could provide the basis of good governance. Understand, children? While directing the government through the planning and development process in the country, these guidelines thus came to be known as Directive Principles of State Policy. See, I have written here. It is, see, once again I'll repeat to you, children. It is nothing but they incorporated certain guidelines which could provide the basis of good governance while directing the government through the planning and development process in the country. And these guidelines came to be known as the Directive Principles of State Policies, children. So, it contained in the part 4 of the constitution, that is in our constitution, in the 4th part of our India's constitution, the guidelines are not enforceable by law. The government is expected to keep these points in mind while framing the policies. When they started to frame the policies, they kept certain things in their mind to get the benefits for the people. So, the next one is aims and objectives. What are the aims and objectives here? See, children, the aims and objectives of the Directive Principle is to establish a welfare state. A welfare state, it aims at doing so by. So, what are that? It is promoting social, economic and political justice. Promoting social, political and economic. Political justice and economic. Understand, children? The next one is raising the standard of living of the people by minimizing inequalities. Minimizing.
The next one is minimizing inequalities in income. Inequalities in income.
That is income, status, opportunities, and facilities also it will come over there, children. The next one is promoting international peace and
security. Promoting international peace and security.
See children, now the aims and objectives, welfare, or it is about the welfare of the state. So in that they brought some policies, that is promoting social, political justice.